Man is a social being, not meant to live in solitude and isolation. But in this city, that's exactly what happens. Try as we do to fool ourselves, the evidence is all around us. Dealers and pushers offer a distraction to those who prefer the wool to be pulled over their eyes. And whores roam the streets, preying on those in desperate need of intimacy. I do not pretend that I am an exception. Far from it. I am probably the most closed off, lonely person in this city. The only difference between them and me is I don't struggle. I simply accept my role. This place is enough to drive anyone crazy. It's given me a life of mood swings, sleepless nights, and an overactive mind. Now I'm to take these pills to keep me normal. I am not the problem. Is it not normal for someone to react this way in such a miserable environment? Cats. A strip joint on the poorer side of town. The worst kind of place you can imagine drinking in. The whole club is stained with ash and smoke covering the dark corners where you get a little bit more than it says on the flyers. For a price. Most of the girls here are only a stone's throw away from walking the streets, but they have a roof over them. And protection from what goes on out there.
Another drink?
No. You know what I want.
She's different. The way she carries herself, her movements, always so elegant and graceful. She's how women should look. I don't know her real name. Perhaps I don't want to. She's my vice. My distraction. A rose between thorns. My sweet Cressida. She's here, waiting for me each time, always looking more dazzling and exciting than the last. Nobody could understand what we share. Nobody would believe something so beautiful could be found here. Not in this town. It's an empty existence. There's no getting around that. But the way I see it, the world needs someone like me. Society works by having people to measure their own success and happiness by. Parents and education boards scare the impressionable with stories like mine. Thank you.
me the drink?
Where is Cressida?
Jane, quit last week. She worked in the new pool bar by the station. Got a new girl starting today. You could be her first.
What's your problem?
The last few days hasn't been much more than a dream. All I remember is finally chipping away whatever sanity was left. No. How could she do this to me? She takes Cressida away and leaves me nothing but the hollow shell of what we used to be. It has become clear to me how this must end. I've sat here waiting for what seems like an eternity. I don't know if she's working tonight. I don't even know if she works here at all. Cressida wouldn't work in a place like this. Why would she? She's better than a pub full of loners and losers.
Shakespeare. Good book?
It's a play, and yes, very.
Never liked Shakespeare. Couldn't understand it. Have you read it all?
After the last act. But then I know how it finishes. What's your name?
Jane.
Well, it's nice speaking to you. Jane.
He had no right to take Cressida away from me. She is to blame. She has left me no option. This is the only way I will ever see her again.
Ah! Quiet. You know what I want.
No, please.
Give me Cressida.
What?
Cressida.
I don't understand. I am Cressida.
No, you're not. Your skin's pale and colourless. Your hair is lifeless. You don't walk the same. You don't even smell the same. I want to see Cressida.
This was the only way it could end. From the very beginning, like all tragedies, the final act brings death and heartbreak. This is my tragedy, my closing act. My sweet Cressida. Without her, I am alone.
Hey, anything I can do to put a smile back on that handsome face?
Do I think I'll be caught? Well, it's easy to fade away when no one knows your name.